Welcome to another episode of the Kyber Lab. This is episode 9, and we're going to look at Emperor Palpatine versus Thrawn. This is a strange counter. You don't see it that often. You do see Thrawn on defense quite a bit, but oftentimes with Chupio and C-3PO, not so much with the characters we have here, Admiral Piet and Shore Trooper. It's really a tank outlast team. In the Kyber Lab, we focus on three things. We want to max your banners, remove the RNG altogether, and avoid as many mistakes as possible. So, in this fight, you should be aiming for about 53 banners with all the turn meter advantage you have with the Emperor Palpatine lead and Tarkin in here. Thrawn should be taking a lot of turns and with his heal and protection regeneration. Should be easy to stall out at the end. In this particular fight, it's a little bit different because the Shore Trooper is only gear 12, so he dies pretty quickly. Palp really needs to have relics, otherwise he'll die. He's too fragile otherwise. Generally, the rest should be, you can be even less relics than the opponent. You have turn meter, they have sustain, so you need some damage. In this case, your Palp needs to be alive as long as possible to do the damage. The mod check to see if Piet is modded for damage, because he can actually put out reasonable DPS. Know the turn order, you don't have to go first, which helps, but you don't have to. And the goal here is to kill Thrawn as soon as possible, because that takes away all of the enemy team's sustain. And really the danger, the fracture, which is the main thing you have to worry about. The Emperor's trap stacks from Piet are a bit worrisome too, but they don't have the turn meter that goes along with the Emperor's trap that you normally get in the troopers. So it's mostly just additional damage, and you'll naturally wear it away. Now, like it'll wear off whenever you take a turn, one of your characters. You need to kill Thrawn as soon as possible. Keep your own Palpatine alive and land shock where you can, which prevents the turn meter gain that Thrawn gets. That Thrawn gives anytime a team member has a debuff, they resist a debuff or they suffer a debuff. There's almost no RNG here, assuming you keep your Palp alive. So let's see how the fight plays out. You go first, that's nice. Go for a fracture on Shore. Yeah, easy. Now they go for a daze, that's fine. They target Tarkin. That's a little bit unfortunate, but not that big of a deal. In this case, you should go for a shock on Shore Trooper. However, it's not too bad. You got the ability block for a moment there. Targeting Piet in this case is definitely the wrong choice. Thrawn counterattacks too, but Piet counterattacks quite a bit more, and he'll call somebody to assist with his basic as well. So you're getting double hit for no reason. See if the stun lands. Nope, they get a lot of turn meter regardless. In this case, you can see the Shore is pretty fragile, so good to try and kill him first. In this case, yep, go for Thrawn. Yeah. In this situation, I would certainly try and go for Grand Admiral Thrawn first. He's the most dangerous character. Going for the heal, it's interesting. You see how close he's getting to dying. Stun. It's really... yeah. Okay, so now Piet gets some buffs there. So again, have to make sure not to target him whenever possible. Going for Thrawn is perfectly good here. If you do have the opportunity to hit people with your Thrawn's basic, that's nice. Just keep in mind that they won't get the speed up and ability block when shock is on them, which is totally fine. And now here we're well in control and finish out pretty easily. But notice all the extra damage that Piet has now after Shore Trooper died. You really have to be careful of your Emperor Palpatine or other characters you have if they have, if they're your DPS instead of Palpatine. And do not attack Piet unless you really have to. He should usually be the second or the last person. But anyway, an easy 50 points. In a different turn order, it could have been a 53 or 54. But yeah, a good way to fight an uncommon team. Hope it was helpful. Cheers.